getting over it, and I would have never found what I was good at because I would have given up. For example, my brother Wayne taught me how to ride a horse. I've been around him my whole life, and he had me ride every day until I got better. When we started going out to pasture and riding on the trail ride, it was difficult at first, but it eventually became easier. It was the same with the motorcycle, only my friends taught me. The hardest part about it was holding the bike while starting it, since I had the type of motorcycle I had to stick start. Another example is when I was a kid, I wanted to learn how to do gymnastics. I thought that training on the uneven bars or to do the stunts on the balance beam would be fun, but before I could do that, I had to learn the basics. I started out with the cartwheels, up and roll, and backspin. The thing about it though was that my left shoulder had torn muscles and bent, so I could never learn how to do them correctly. The instructors told my mom that they did not think I was able to do it, so I refused to give up. I continued going back and did it for 3 years before I finally said it was enough. Though I never could do it the correct way, I never could. I pushed myself until I had enough. Another thing I never gave up was school. I'm hearing and heard in both ways and my family. I stayed in private school up to my 3rd grade year, and then moved to public school in 4th grade. Most of my teachers did not think I would succeed or do it well for hearing school. I was slower at learning in the beginning and did struggle a lot with reading and English, mostly because I could not understand the words and could not pronounce them right. I was taking extra classes during recess to be with the audiologist at the school, learning how to pronounce words and smooth my lips. I struggled with it for a long period and thought I could not do it, but Mom always told me I could do whatever I put my mind to. Therefore, I thought to myself that I wanted to succeed and prove to my teachers that they were wrong. I continued studying and going to my speech classes, and Mom and I read books every night. I learned to accommodate. In the end, I was doing better than most students in my class. If I had given up, I would have never made it as far as I did. If I had continued telling myself I could not, then I would have gotten nowhere. I have taken that word can't completely out of my vocabulary. I will not give up without trying. That is why I believe can't